Hello, everyone, and welcome into Western Wilds on $1 million in bees. So, it has been a good while since we've seen y'all, and I'm just going to go ahead and show y'all what we have done. If you look directly in front of you, you will see we have gotten a bunch more beehives. We got a good amount of money off of finding some gold nuggets laying around here. And so I spent it on, well, of course, more beehives. And this morning we have got out here and loaded up the trailer and semi that we bought in the last video. Well, we have spent the morning out here loading it up with honey. So now we are going to head to the sale with it and hopefully get a good amount for it. Right now is one of the highest times to sell it. So we are going to get on out here and I'm going to try to get it sold today. And hopefully everything goes well. Yeah, that is if I can stay on the highway and keep it in gear. But anyway, I'm going to head on to where we are going to sell the honey. So I'll catch you back whenever we are getting just a little bit closer. All right, everyone. So we are just pulling up here. And if you remember, we actually have to swing out a good bit, swing back in, and just like the last time, I overshot it. So we've got to turn back around here and try to get around. And that way the trailer and everything will fit across the bridge into the train yard, which is the best place to sell if I will quit hitting things. Must be hit things day, because that we have done that now a few times. All right, but we are getting in here now, so I'm going to get up here and go ask the guy where we got to drop off this time, because it has been different a time or two. So I'm going to run in here and see where we're going to drop off, and I'll catch you back here in just a few minutes when we get done doing that. All right, everyone, so I just got done talking to the guy. We just have to unload all the pallets right here, and then they will go ahead and move them where they need to go. So I'm going to go ahead and move the pallets, and I will catch you back here in a few minutes whenever I get that done. All right, everyone, so we just got all the pallets unloaded, and that put us up there at $94,452. And that is not too bad for the amount of honey we brought in. That's a pretty good amount worth. So I think we're going to reach our $1 million goal pretty quick here. But hey, the more we can expand, the quicker we'll get there. If I hadn't been able to expand as quick as we were, then hey, we wouldn't have been able to get there that quick. But actually, I'm just going to stop right here and pull out my phone for just a second. And the first thing that I'm going to do with this money is I'm going to pay back a little bit of this loan. So as you can see, we got a pretty steep loan out, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pay it back some of it and leave us with about $4,452. But that will get some of the loan paid down, and we'll just keep working at that until we get it all paid down, and then we're making pure profit and expanding. But there's nothing much to go on right now, so I'm going to go ahead and head home, and I will catch you here in just a little bit. All right, everyone, it is February the 1st here, and we've got a good bit of snow on the ground, and I really wasn't expecting it. And I really don't have anything to clear, and I don't much think that our semi is going to be able to get out. And as you can see, we're going to need to haul honey out pretty soon. So I think we're going to jump up in our Chevrolet here, and I think we're going to run down to the store and see if I can find a snowplow or something for our skid steer. Although that is going to be a cold ride with no cab, but it'll be okay. So I'm going to head down to the store and see if I can pick up a bucket, and I will catch you back whenever I get up there and see if we can get a bucket or not. All right, everyone, so they didn't have a snow plow, but they did have a bucket that'll work on my skid steer, but it wouldn't quite fit on the back of my truck. So it's just sort of, I don't know why the view keeps doing that stupid thing, but it just sort of sits there. So I've just got to sort of drive home, carefully, because it's sliding and the view keeps messing up. But anyway, we're going to head on home with this, get it out with the skid steer, and see if we can't clear out a way to get the semi through. So I'll catch back when we get home and we're starting to do stuff like that. All right, everyone, so we have made it home. So I have got to get the forks off the front of the skid steer. I think I'm just going to try to set them off right here. Maybe. Let's see. There we go. We got them off. Just had to kick a pin a little and get it fixed. All right. So now we'll go ahead and pull up here to the bucket. And it's a pretty good sized bucket. He said it was made for this skid steer, and it looks the right to be the right color and everything. So sort of just had to take his word for it. Skid steer does, you could definitely tell it's slick out though, because it's skid steer sliding around a little. But I'm going to get this bucket off the back of the truck. It's going to be a little bit difficult. I'm going to have to murk away a little bit. But I'll catch you back here in just a few minutes whenever I get that done. All right, so we have gotten the bucket off of the truck. So the first thing I'm going to try to do is right here where the honey's at. I'm going to see if we can't push it out of the way right here in order to get a semi in here. And then I've got to try to clear the semi out a little bit. Shouldn't need to go very far though. So I'm just going to dump a pile right there. And then we sort of got right where it's at. But then we're going to need a way to get out of the driveway. But I'm going to work at this for just a little while. So I'll catch you back here in a little bit whenever I get it done. All right, everyone, so it has took a little bit of time, but I have gotten the part of the yard that we needed. You can come right through here, and the county should take care of this pretty soon or something or another. Should be able to drive over. We'll figure it out. And I didn't leave a skid steer like that, but apparently I left a hydraulic on. All right, so that fixed that. Now we gotta see if the semi here is gonna fire up. So we're gonna jump up inside it here and we're gonna see if it's gonna fire up. Go ahead and put that thing in neutral. Oh, that was close. Just trying. All right, and it is started up. Alright, so we'll let that sit here and warm up a little bit, and we'll go ahead and take the skid steer and put it back in the shed right over here. I reckon we'll leave the bucket on it, and I should have really plowed out where the truck's at, but I'm probably just going to pull the truck back in the shed and be done with that for now. So alright, so that right there should work. Go ahead and fire up the Chevrolet here, and we'll just go ahead and pull it back underneath the shed, because I failed to do that earlier for some reason or another. But all right, so we got there out of the shed. So we're gonna go over here and hop up in the semi, and hopefully we don't have any trouble getting out here. We're gonna go ahead and put this thing in the first gear and try to creep. Oh yeah, no problem getting out of there. And we just got to make that turn right there. And we managed to smack a pole somehow. And we're going to go ahead and just get flipped around here like this. And I'm going to get backed up and get these pallets of honey loaded. So I'll catch you back here in just a few minutes whenever I get all of them loaded up and ready to go. All right, everyone. So as you can see, I've got most of the honey loaded up. But I'm going to wait just a little bit and let some more honey spawn in so I can take that as well. So I'm going to go in the house, get some hot chocolate, lay back in the recliner, and get warm for a little while. I'll catch you back here in just a little bit whenever we go to take that in. Oh me. All right, it is now May, and we have got some more honey to take in, as you can see. We're going to wait for all of it to finish getting out of the beehives and everything like that before we go to load it in. So I'm going to wait around just a little bit get that done, do a little maintenance on the skid steer we need to do real quick while it's doing that. So I'll catch you back here in just a few minutes whenever we get that done. Okay. All right. We finally got the tire fixed. It had a little slow leak in it, so I fixed it up and patched it. So we're going to go ahead and let this down. All right. So our truck should be about as full as it can get. Looks like we got two more pallets that just spawned, so we'll go ahead and load them. I think that's about all we can honestly get. We'll see, maybe a load. Nope, that is all it can take. So we are going to go ahead and just head back to the train yard, that way we can go sell it. And it is also raining really hard right now, or decently hard. So shouldn't make too much of a difference, but the honey will be a little bit wet, so I hope they don't dock us for that. But anyway, I'm going to get heading on out to the train yard, so I will catch you back whenever we get there. All right, everyone. So once again, we're just pulling up, and as always, this is just going to be a tradition, I'm pretty sure. We overshoot it, of course. I think that's just going to be how it is around here, honestly. That's just sort of becoming part of the routine, is overshooting it, backing up, coming around. Yeah, that's just becoming part of the routine. But anyway, good news, we're here. So we need to come on up here and, of course, see where the guy wants it unloaded this time. So once I do that, I will get where he wants it and we'll unload. So I'll catch you back here in just a few minutes while I see where the guy wants it. All right. All right. Thank you. All right, so he said that this time they're just wanted in the same place as the time before, which is just right here. So I'm going to go ahead and get unloading this. So I'll catch you back here in just a little bit whenever we get that done. All right, everyone. So I just have got that unloaded so we can head on home. But real quick, once again, we're going to come in here and pay off just a little bit of our debt. So we're going to start repaying some of it. And once again, what's going to take us down, I'm going to let it take us down pretty low. But, all right, we took us down to $1,784. So that should pay off. That paid off a good bit of it. It's slowly but surely, but we're getting it paid off. And that's the important thing, is that we do get it paid off. Because the longer we keep the loan out, well, the more they charge us in interest and fine and everything like that, and it just becomes ridiculous. So, the more we can pay off, the quicker, the better. But anyway, I'm gonna head on home, so I will catch you back whenever we get there. All right, everyone, and we are pulling back up to the farm, and I have already slapped the building once again because the steering radius on this thing sucks. Oh, but we do have a good amount of honey to sell, but that will be another video. So, anyways, guys, thank you for watching. Hope you have a great rest of your day, and bye for now.
A few days before he turned 80, he was sitting out back in a rocker. He said, "What you been up to lately?" Told him chasing a dollar, and in between sips of coffee, he poured this wisdom out. Said, "If you want my 2 cents on making a dollar count, buy dirt, find the one you can't live without. Get a ring, let your knee hit the ground. Do what you love, but call it work. And throw a little money in the plate at church. Send your prayers up and your roots down deep. Add a few limbs to your family tree and watch their pencil marks in the grass in the yard all grow up. Cause the truth about it is, it all goes by real quick. You can't buy happiness, but you can buy dirt."